Hi viewers, welcome to my channel. This is Lakshmi Prasanna. Today our topic is parts of speech. Parts of speech. According to the work done in a sentence, words are divided into different kinds. These are called the parts of speech. As we have different organs in our body to perform different functions, basic on the work done, in a sentence also, the words are divided into different kinds. And these are called parts of speech. There are 8 parts of speech in English language. As we also can say, the part of speech indicates how the word functions in meaning as well as grammatically within the sentence. An individual word can function as more than one part of speech when used in different circumstances. Okay. Understanding of the 8 parts of speech in English language is essential for determining the correct definition of a word when using the dictionary also. The 8 parts of speech in English language are noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, conjunction, and interjection. Now, let us know briefly about these 8 parts of speech in a word or a sentence. First one is a noun. Noun is a naming word. Pronoun. Word used instead of a noun, that is in place of a noun. Verb. Verb is a doing word. Adverb. Word used to add something to the meaning of an adverb, of a verb, an adjective, and an adverb itself. Adjective. Adjective is a describing word. Preposition. Preposition is a relating word. Conjunction. Conjunction is a joining word to join words or sentences. Interjection. Interjection is a word expressing sudden feeling. This is the table of the 8 parts of speech. Coming to the noun. Noun is a word used as a name of a person, place or thing. Noun indicates the names of persons, places, things, animals, etc. The things include all objects that we can see, hear, taste, touch or smell, and something that we can think of but cannot perceive by senses. Proper nouns always start with a capital letter. Common nouns do not. Nouns can be singular or plural, concrete or abstract. Nouns show possession by adding apostrophe s, that is Ramas, Geetas, Kavitas, etc. Nouns can function in different roles within a sentence. A noun can be a subject, direct object, indirect object, subject complement or object of a preposition. Here, the name of Akbar. Akbar is a proper noun. So, it is denoted by a capital letter. The rose smells sweet. Rose is the name of a flower. And he won. His grace won his honor. These are abstract nouns. Kolkata is on the banks of the river Hooghly. The name of the city is Kolkata, so it is a proper noun, and Hooghly is the name of the river, and so it is also a proper noun. Girl, if you take girl, teacher, these are the common nouns. Hari is a boy. Hari is the name of a boy, so Hari is also denoted by capital letter and it is said as proper noun. Chemistry is the name of the subject, and so chemistry book is kept on the table. Chemistry is the name of the subject, and we can say it as a proper noun. And these are the nouns. Nouns is a word for a person, place, thing or an idea. Man, girl, teacher, these are all examples of nouns. And next, coming to the pronouns. What are pronouns? Pronouns are the words that is used instead of a noun. Is called a pronoun. Pronoun means for a noun that is in the place of a noun. That is, it is a substitute of a noun. A pronoun is a word used in place of a noun. A pronoun is usually substituted for a specific noun, which is called its antecedent. In some sentences, we use pronouns. I, we, he, she, it, and they in the place of a noun. I for singular, we for plural, he for male. That is, he for
boys or gents or girl or boys, and she for female. She for female. So the pronoun is a word used for a noun. She is represented for the girl. Next, coming to the verb. Verb is a word that is used to express an action or state or being, is said to be a verb. Verb is a doing word. A verb is a word used to tell or assert something about some person or thing. Verb comes from Latin word verbum. The verb is a sentence expressing action or being. There is a main verb and sometimes one or more helping verbs. A verb must agree with its subject in number, both as singular or both are plural. In this sentence, Hari laughs. Laughs is an action. Lakshmi writes stories. It is writing is also an action. The bell rings. Rings is an action. I feel sorry. It is a state. Or the cat is dead. It is also a state, thus representing the state of the cat. Glass is brittle. It shows the glass state. State of the glass. Brittleness shows the state of the glass. And so, the verb is a word which expresses an action or state or being of a word. So, called as what we call, that is an action word, is a verb. Now, coming to the adverb. A word used to add something to the meaning of a verb, an adjective or another adverb, is an adverb. An adverb modifies or describes a verb, an adjective or another adverb. An adverb describes, it describes or modifies, it changes an adjective, a verb, another adverb, but never a noun. It usually answers the questions of when, where, how, why, under what conditions or to what degree. Adverbs often end with ly, quickly. Write the notes, quickly, ly. The flower is very beautiful. Here, very is an adverb which is acting upon the adjective. How is the flower beautiful? Next, coming to the adjective. Adjective is a describing word. Adjectives describe what kind of, how many, and what color of a person, place, animals, and things, etc. Pretty, old, blue, smart. An adjective is a word used with a noun to add something for its meaning. Okay, it describes the noun. The boy is lazy. Here, the boy is described as lazy. He is considered as lazy fellow. It is a cloudy day. How is the day? The day is cloudy. How? It is a cloudy day. The ant is a tiny insect. It shows how the ant is. It is tiny. The hand has 5 fingers. How many fingers? It answers the question, how many? So, it is an adjective. It shows what kind of, how many, and what color of persons, places, animals, and things. So called as describing sentence. Next, coming to the preposition. Preposition is a relating word. A word placed before a noun or a pronoun to show in what relation does the noun or pronoun stand with something else in a given sentence. The girl is fond of music. The girl is the noun and she is fond of. Fond of what? A fond of music. In, on, with, by, for, from, etc. These are all the prepositions. A preposition is a word placed before a noun or pronoun to form a phrase modifying another word in the sentence. It always functions as an adjective or as an adverb. A preposition is a word placed before a noun or pronoun to form a phrase modifying another word in the sentence. It is always a part of a prepositional phrase. A fair lady sat under a tree. She sat where? She sat under a tree. It is relating the noun with the noun or pronoun with another, with something else in the sentence. The book, where it is? It is on the table. It relates. So called as relating word. So preposition is a relating word. It relates noun or a pronoun with another, with something else in a given sentence. So preposition is considered as a relating word shortly. And next we move to conjunction. What is a conjunction? Conjunction is a joining word. It joins words or sentences. A conjunction joins words, phrases or clauses. A conjunction joins words, phrases or clauses and indicates the relationship between the elements joined. There are two types of conjunctions: coordinating conjunctions and subordinating conjunctions. What are coordinating conjunctions? Coordinating conjunctions connect grammatically equal elements. What are coordinating conjunctions? And, but, or, nor, first, so, it. Here, he ran fast is a sentence and he missed the train is also another sentence. We are combining both these sentences by using a conjunctional word, that is but. He ran fast but missed the train. So we are joining two sentences, so called the word which is used here, that is but, is a joining word, that is a conjunction. Rama and Hari are cousins. Rama is the name of a person, that is a noun, and Hari is also a noun. Rama and Hari. We are combining both of these with, by means of a conjunction and. So it joins both the words, that is both the nouns, so called as conjunction or the joining word, coordinating conjunction. And subordinating conjunctions connect clauses that are not equal, because, although, while, since, etc. are the subordinating conjunctions. There are another type of conjunctions as well. And coming to the words which are used as conjunctions are and, but, or, because, if, unless, since, while. These are all types of examples of conjunctions, the joining words. And interjections. The last but not the least is the interjection, the word expressing sudden feelings. An interjection is a word used to express our emotions. It is often followed by an exclamatory point or the exclamatory mark. Examples: ha, ho, wow, oops. If we feel sad, happy, according to our mood, we use all these expressing words. The words used to express sudden feelings or the emotions, we use these interjections. Lars, she's dead. Hooray, we have won the match or the won the game. We are in an excited mood that we won the game or match. Lars, ho, ha, hooray. These are all the interjections. Some of the grammaticians include determiners among the parts of speech. Determiners. What are determiners? These are the words that determine or limit the meaning of the nouns that follows. They limit the meaning of the nouns. A, an, the, each, any, some, one, etc. These are the determiners. The words determine or limit the meaning. A cup of coffee. An umbrella. They are limiting the meaning to that particular noun only. So
this is all about the 8 parts of speech. If you like my video, please do subscribe my channel. Thank you a lot.